Hello and welcome to the first episode of Star Wars Empire at War, a classic RTS that, you know, is about Star Wars. We're going to be doing the campaigns for the base game, both of them, and then we're going to be doing the expansion campaign, and then I actually went to play some of the Empire at War expanded mods. There's some really great mods for this game. So we're not going to be doing the tutorial. I could theoretically be doing them just to show you guys, but I feel like they're cute, and they do have some story events, but we're going to be doing the campaign from the get-go. Oh, oops. Sinclair, new campaign. So you get to pick between the two factions. This one is basically about... I don't want to spoil either of them, but we're going to play on hard because, I don't know, I'm sadomasochistic, and we're going to be playing the Empire first. So, let's go. A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. Star Wars. Empire at War. The entire galaxy is under the rule of the tyrannical Galactic Empire. The only remaining resistance is a small rebel alliance that dares to challenge their military supremacy. The impending creation of the Empire's ultimate weapon, the Death Star, threatens to crush the rebellion. Once operational, the Empire will have the power to destroy an entire planet. Threatening to turn the tide of the struggle is an unknown Imperial traitor who deals in military secrets. The Emperor has tasked his apprentice, Darth Vader, with tracking down and eliminating this double agent. So the texts are different, I believe, depending upon which faction you are. Oh, they are different. They're guaranteed different. I wish it didn't say tyrannical. It was like, the Empire has brought order to the worlds and the pathetic Rebel Alliance, something like that for the Empire one. This game obviously came out before Disney's acquisition of Star Wars, so this is a very different story than, you know, anything in the new canon.
My lord, we've located a small rebel outpost using the nearby abandoned communications tower to receive Imperial transmissions.
Have the rebels detected our presence?
No, my lord. We jammed their sensors and communications before we landed.
I hope that you are not mistaken, Commander. We will eliminate the rebel forces here and discover the identity of the traitor with one swift strike.
Yes, sir.
All right, so here we are with Mr. Darth Vader. So we're supposed to select our units and destroy this rebel base right here. So this is a pretty interesting RTS.
Reporting.
I'd say it's a mix between the Total War series, because you have a galactic map, which we'll come to later. You have kind of like a Dawn of War squad-based system, where you have a limited amount of groups of units, but then you also have these really powerful heroes. So we're actually going to mostly be using Darth Vader. Yeah, Darth Vader is very strong.
Prepare to die.
Ready. All right, men, take cover.
I don't believe they say anything funny when you click them repeatedly.
Let's get out of here.
Ready to go. Engaging enemy.
While they're shooting Darth Vader, I may as well.
Blast them.
So every individual unit has its own little health pool, but they're kind of like clumped together. Now, of course, this is sort of a tutorial with Darth Vader anyway, so they kind of hold your hand a bit when you do stuff.
They will join us or die.
Awaiting orders. Scouting.
You found something.
Moving to secondary position.
I'll say, while maybe not the kiddiest of Star Wars properties, this still does kind of target, I'm going to say, teenagers, like 10 to like 14-year-old, something like that. So it's not that gritty. There are no real blood effects. There aren't really... It's not StarCraft. It's not WarCraft. It's a bit older.
Always ready, sir. On my way.
And, yeah, so we're going to be doing both campaigns. It's going to be pretty fun. And then, at some point, yeah, as I said, I want to check out the Empire War Expanded mods. So, Corey loses, if you know who he is. If not, you should check him out if you like this content, because he does some amazing stuff. He and his whole team have been working hard creating some pretty amazing stuff.
Scouting area. We'll back you up.
Yeah, you can build, like, healing pods. We're going to build one just for Darth Vader, so you can head back and heal if you need him.
As the Emperor wills, all too easy. The Rebels will see no more use from this communication center. Destroy it.
So what is interesting is that we can go into this and just watch him, like, this is a battle cam. I believe you can use, like, some commands, but I'm unfamiliar with which. I'll have to look that up in the future so that I can give a more dynamic battle cam experience. Okay, you guys are actually going to go there. Crush this.
It will be done.
So these are anti-infantry turrets. Turrets are really strong in this game, let me tell you.
Awaiting orders. Right away. Moving out. Heading out. Enemy sighted.
I should have built the thing there. Oh well.
Copy.
May as well have it.
Fall out. I copy. Let's move out.
Roger. Right away, sir. Reporting in.
So heroes are kind of overpowered, and losing them... So this is a story mission, so we're not allowed to lose Lord Vader. We have the objectives right here. But on the regular campaign map, you can lose a hero, and that's not actually a problem because they'll respawn after a while. I mean, it does take a significant amount of time, so you don't want to, like, repeatedly lose them for no reason, but...
The communication array is destroyed, Lord Vader.
Alert all commands.
Ready.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Keep going.
You presume too much.
Ready to go. Enemy spotted.
Form up.
What's interesting is every unit is, like, balanced.
Awaiting orders.
So they have their strengths and their weaknesses.
I find we must take down this shield before we attack. Destroy the power source before we advance on the base.
So theoretically, you could just go and attack the base and I think win regardless. But they're kind of showing you, like, do this, and that would be smart. So yeah, it's kind of a tutorial, but not quite.
As the Emperor
same
will,
with the first two or three rebel missions, I think.
And fortify that location to bring in reinforcements. Now you will know true
always
suffering.
Ready, sir. Hostiles.
Found something.
Awaiting orders. Move out.
Yeah, the shield kind of blocks everything from
right
going
away.
At least in. I don't know if it blocks stuff coming out, but...
Moving to that area, sir.
Affirmative. Reporting in. Attack!
What is your directive?
Roger that. Fire!
Here is the power generator. Attack it at once.
I will say that this the base
way.
Game is fun, a bit dated, but it's
we're landing
cute.
Reinforcements. Stand by.
Perfect. So these control points, it's a very like map control version of a game where you control points that allow you to drop in reinforcements.
The power generator is down. Finish the rest of the rebels.
What?
Copy. Attack that target!
May dispense with the
that's interesting that the rebels actually charge in. So we can see the base here. Pretty substantial one.
I copy.
You can use control groups if you want to. It's not a bad idea.
Standing by.
Actually,
all are ready. I've got them on scopes.
I copy.
We're just gonna send in our forces.
What now? I am ready. I have you now.
Yes, sir.
Do not fail me.
Come here, please.
Join us or die.
Yes, Commander.
Reporting.
Yes.
Order acknowledged.
Time order. Copy. Roll out.
What these can do is they can actually overrun troops.
There they are. Initiate sweep. Setting course. Changing course.
I see they're running.
Ready. Over there.
Like, I don't know that many games that use the fact that vehicles could trample their enemies. And then when destroying, like, base structures like these, a few, like, squads will come out.
Ready to go. Targeting.
What is it? Found something. Your destiny lies with me.
Yeah, these are the buildings actually used to build all the units on the galactic map. We're gonna have the final squad right there.
We'll back you up.
Your incompetence is troubling. The rebels were clearly alerted to our presence.
My lord, it is likely that the traitor we are hunting may have...
You failed me for the last time, Commander. I will be better off without your services. Trooper, did you find anything in your search?
Some of the equipment we found carries pirate insignias. The rebels may be working with them.
They must be trading information on our cargo routes for supplies from the pirates. Reconstruct their communications. They will lead us to the rebellion.
Yes, sir.
We are victorious.
And after every battle, you get a losses screen, which is quite nice.
My lord, reports are coming in from Fondor that rebel forces have routed our troops and taken control of some local settlements.
This meaningless retaliation only serves to give away their location. Eliminate them quickly and recover any communications you may find in the rubble.
Mission log updated. Construction complete.
So I'm going to be pretty, I guess, a little bit gamey. So as you can see here, this is the galactic map.
Construction complete.
These are the different objectives we have. Crush, kill, destroy. Crush, kill, destroy. The rebels have captured Fondor. Send your forces there to crush their pitiful uprising. Teach these rebels a lesson they won't soon forget. So we build a ground force to assault and recapture Fondor. So yeah, the galactic map, you can play this as a version. Like, the game is very loud. I'm going to be lowering it a little bit. Audio. Master volume a little bit lower, please. Actually, dialogue a little bit lower as well.
Most impressive.
Most impressive. I'm going to let it go. So, we are playing on hard. That means that the missions are slightly more difficult. The rebels are slightly more difficult.
Constructing.
We can get the pro droids. Let's get one. Now, there is a bit of a trick to this campaign if you find it difficult. So, as you can see here, all these worlds are grayed out. Like, you cannot travel there. And I believe these are basically neutral. And then via events, as we complete options or like quests in the stories, more and more worlds will unlock. So let's see if we can go, no, not here, be here. Yeah, so as you can see, the rebels, they had I guess they have all the planets at now. I'm unsure, but they can only attack us from these two planets. They cannot attack us from any others. I'm 99% sure. So a trick, if you're having difficulty, is that we would capture Terrace before we capture Fondor. Capture Fondor. From there, when the next few planets unlock, capture all of them aside from the mission objective, and then you know, snowball that way. And also abuse the fact that when they can't attack us, we can have massive amounts of mines.
Recruiting troops. Constructing unit.
Now, let's
recruitment canceled.
What is interesting is that every single planet has, well, first off, they have an amount of money that they give. And we've increased it a lot. Like, mines give an insane amount of money, of course, on.
Complete.
They don't give nearly as much on Anaxes. Secondly,
Construction complete.
Each planet has a space station and an amount of building slots. So for example, this planet can only have up to a level 4 space station, which is actually quite high. But as you can see, like a few other planets can have up to 5, which is a max. That means Star Destroyers and a whole bunch of different things. Imperial Star Destroyers, not just like these regular Acclimator Star Destroyers. And then finally, the
construction complete.
This shows the specific like bonuses on the planet as well. So this planet has a higher than average credit production rate. Oh, and it's clear. This is a rainy planet, but I believe Star Destroyers, yes. Victory Star Destroyers cost 20% less to build on all planets. Very nice. Now, what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to...
Unit in production.
I do not believe that Vader is... Yeah, because you have to travel through Fondor. And I believe there will be a Rebel force right there. Let's check that out, actually. Spy for me, please.
Construction complete.
Build this.
Vehicle in production. Vehicle in production. Building under construction.
There does not seem to be a space force. I could be wrong. Let's see if we're screwed over. No. Okay. Well, I guess this is the tutorial portion.
Inputting coordinates. Navigating.
That is not going to stop us from taking Terrors first, though.
On my way.
Although, maybe I'll take Fondor and then end the mission. Let me just take and see how long I recorded.
Complete.
I think we are actually going to take Terrors first,
confirm.
Yes. And then we'll take Fondor.
Complete.
But let's cruiser speed some things up.
Unit
get another... So yeah, we're kind of out of money cruiser already.
Online. Cruiser online. Cruiser reporting.
I should most definitely get another mine.
Construction.
Cruiser online.
So we actually have pirates here. Reporting. That's right. I forgot about that.
Right away. Roger.
Well, I think we can
Let's
be
go.
Relatively quick. So the pirates aren't super powerful. 8 ships. What's interesting is that eventually, like, the expansion allowed you to choose which ship would attack first. And this one,
complete.
You just get a hodgepodge of ships that will attack your enemy. You have no control over it.
As the Emperor will.
Let's get Terrace.
Tactical battle imminent.
Begin. So the cost of all ships is reduced due to Terrace thriving ship industry. I'm not going to read all these blurbs, but basically Terrace was once rivaling Coruscant, but it was nuked by the Sith in the Nice Old Republic. Very cool. That is also a great game that I might play on the channel. It's so old and so many people have done it that maybe I won't. This is a bit more in line with my other strategy game content on the channel. On the flip side, I did play Jedi Survivor and Jedi Order, so... Jedi Fallen Order and Star Wars Jedi Survivor, so... I might play KOTOR. I mean, they're great games. Any excuse to replay them is, I think, pretty valid. So space stations, what they do is they actually summon more and more enemies. Small ships, like fighters and the Tarkin cruisers right here, they kind of just shoot. The bigger ships have these hard points, and once all the hard points are destroyed, the ship dies. Oh, I hope I think I did not target anything specific. Okay. You know what? Just fire. Fire away. So this should take out the shield generator, I think. Yeah, I mean, bombers are very strong. So the shield generator is almost gone. Tarkin cruiser reporting. Once we've done that, we'll actually get these to go after the stragglers. Get them to start attacking the actually hunt stuff down. We want to take out the hangar because it's the hangar portion of the station that summons reinforcements. We are probably gonna. Oh, we've already lost a Tarkin cruiser. Yeah, it's kind of gonna happen. Lost a second Tarkin cruiser. For the Empire at War Expanded mod, or, you know, if you know what you're doing, it's not that difficult to not lose things. Like, you can kind of overwhelm forces, have good compositions. For this one, every single unit is kind of a bit of a slugger, but it's kind of stupid. So it's a bit difficult to... But I think focusing on a few ships at a time... Yeah, I think that's good. Actually, go after that.
Choose your reinforcements.
Let's speed it up. Oh yeah, we can do the Oh, there are enemies somewhere.
Reporting in. I call, babe.
Are these the last enemies?
What?
I think so. Yay, what an amazing battle cam. Wow. Wow. Okay, where are you at? Where are the last enemies? Ah, there they are.
You may dispense.
I think there is a select all units hotkey, but I, for the life of me, don't know what it is. So this is the super amazing battle cam. It is a bit derpy, I'm not gonna lie. So that was kind of cool. It's kind of cute. Okay. Oh, it actually shows what time it takes to, like, complete stuff. So we're just gonna land Darth Vader, because he is amazing. We're gonna be pretty gung-ho with our forces. Darth Vader, go here. Get some forces.
Can I do? Can I help? Ready. At your service. Can do.
I do not know if that worked, but not the biggest deal if it didn't.
Moving out.
Scanning area.
We're basically going to try to capture this secondary landing pad, get Fall even more forces down, and from there we're just going to destroy them. I am going to start auto-resolving some stuff that isn't mission-specific, maybe. Just because it's a little tedious sometimes. I'm not a huge fan of the ground battles.
Right away.
Advancing. On my way.
Unit capacity. Unit destroyed.
Keep going.
And I'm going to be pretty, like, gung-ho with using my forces. So we can see they are all there, so we may as well just go after them.
Unit destroyed.
Roger that.
Oh, come on, man.
Deploying. Scanning for enemies.
I think technically we actually lost a unit now because of that.
Will do.
The civilians are fodder. Like, they don't.
Awaiting orders.
They're kind of useless.
Providing backup.
Alert.
He's actually
commands.
Building.
Size
wait, ready.
Nothing for the force.
Affirmative.
Let's do that and that. Let's try to see if I can find the building. More Maulers? Yes, please.
Form up.
Initiate sweep.
So I think I'll be structuring the episode so I do one main story objective every episode, something like that. And I think the episode lengths will be about 20 minutes, 25 minutes. If anyone wants to see more or has a request of me showing everything, then they can do so in the comments below. But I think the goal is to actually get to the mods that are honestly better than the base game. The bottom line, right there.
Reporting in. On my way. Roger that.
So I'm going to be a bit more shorter episodes, mostly just showing the story content. I'll be making cuts when I just build up, and I'll be auto-resolving. Maybe I'll show everything, but I'll be a bit more ready and willing to auto-resolve. I think that might actually be a better idea. You guys get to see everything that I do, but
roll out, deploying,
unit destroyed,
scanning for enemies,
nice
sweep, setting course, ready for your orders, sir.
Nice, very good.
Open fire.
So you even have to destroy turrets. Oh, you don't, huh? Well, that is some sort of magical turret right there, suffering, surviving all of that.
System.
You know what? Because it is the first episode, let's make it slightly longer. And yeah, we're just getting more and more resources.
Moving out.
That is the system. I think we have a good enough ground army to just stomp them, but just in case, we are gonna speed through it.
Complete. Constructing unit.
We are kind of limited on how much supply we can have. Recruiting in terms troops. Of units.
Construction crews are online.
I'm not going to be getting any speeders.
Reporting.
Basically useless. And right now we're very shameless with the amount of mines we have. Complete. But we'll be basically selling those as the game goes.
Tarpon crews are reporting.
Replacing them with actual infrastructure. And with, you know, lots of stuff.
Tarpon crews are reporting.
Right away.
Confirmed.
Does this do a breakdown of the unit capacity? No, I don't think so. But basically, a shipyard gives unit capacity and a planet gives unit capacity.
Mauler ready.
All right, we're actually going to end the episode here. I knew I said I was going to do a little bit more and take Fondor, but we're actually approaching, or we've passed 25 minutes. So I think this is a good first episode. We did the first mission objective. We took a planet. Next episode, we'll be taking Fondor and we'll continuing unlocking the galaxy. Doing some more missions. I hope you join me for the next few episodes. We will be uploading content. Star Wars 3 times a week, I believe, will be the schedule. So Sunday through Tuesday. And I upload content on the other days of the week. So subscribe if you're interested. Anyways, I'll see you guys next time. Take care.